534 in progress. In progress. F-534 complete. F-534 in progress. 526 in progress. In progress. Five 34 complete. Five 26 complete. Five 26 in progress. Thank you. 526 complete. Complete. In progress.
What? I forgot to give you your parking pass?
I have my pass.
Didn't Jesus tell you not to drink?
That's right. I don't drink. I already went through that ordeal, but you... no. Well, it's nothing to be ashamed of.
Oh, I'm not ashamed. You can be sure of that.
You know, it's hard to handle some things alone. And sometimes help comes from somewhere you wouldn't expect.
You can say that again.
When I needed help, it was an old man named Tarek Palm, former pastor. They say he was kicked out of the church because he went crazy. I don't know the whole story. Maybe he lost his mind, but he sure didn't lose his instincts. He immediately saw the two things that were ruining my life, lies and stubbornness. So he locked me in the basement.
Lost his mind? Must have been a smart guy.
He locked me up in the basement with the Bible, the Koran, and the Torah. And he told me that he didn't care what I was going to believe, but every righteous man, whatever he believed, had to go through these three steps. Now, the first step is when you choose principles over honesty. And the second step is when you choose honesty over principles. And the third is when you don't need to choose at all, because honesty is your only principle. Now, old man Palm said that he would bring me water every morning and ask, "What stage are you on, son?" 3 weeks later, I answered, "On the third, father." And he let me go. I was a changed man. But I lied about the third stage. I was still stuck on the second one.
Well, I guess that makes you a cheat. And I'm not going to play cards with you. Don't even ask.
The competition between us, it... maybe it was stupid, but...
It was only stupid when you won it.
I cheated, Jack. I won because Lily helped me. Brought me a pile of papers with lots of leads. And somehow, this one was stuck in with the other papers. Of course, I was going to phone it in right then and there. But then I thought, what will happen if I call? The feds will arrest you. But what then? Would that be the end of it? No, of course not. There'll be reporters, and there'll be some kind of investigation, and everyone will be on the hook. Lily, the other cops, our ordinary townspeople, everyone. It's hard to imagine how this would hit our town. Jack, I'm sure you understand. Lily wanted me to take things over gradually, you know, so we could work together for a few days and keep everything calm, right? But you could keep things even calmer. You can leave early in the morning. You can disappear, and no one else in Sharpwood will ever hear from you. It'll be like you were never here, like you got off the bus, you took one breath of icy air, and immediately decided you needed to get out of here. I mean, after all, who would hide from justice in a freezer? Don't be ashamed, Jack. Drink up. You haven't got through this yet. I have.
I need to talk to Liam Henderson. I know, but it's important. Yes, I'll hold.
Jack, how could I let this happen? Who could have done this?
Captain Carter caught a bunch of scumbags lately. And he made a lot of enemies. Any one of those cocksuckers could have decided
that... Anyone could. Anyone could have. But someone did. Anyone could, but someone decided. How did I let this happen?
We will try to find
the... Of course we'll try, Jack. Of course we'll try.
The one who did this will be punished. I have no doubt.
You have no doubt. Of course you have no doubt. The person who did this has to be punished. What else could happen?
Lily, we did everything we could. You did everything you could.
Of course. Even more. I did more. More than necessary. More than this fucking town can take.
7 in progress. Progress. In progress. Complete. Five-52, complete. Code I.
Did something happen?
I saw the file. Captain Carter's. Captain Carter's murder. So that's how it was.
Everything points to this, Lily. Everything points to this, and we have no reason to doubt that—
You have no reason to doubt. I have no reason to doubt. You're a cop, a very experienced cop. Much more experienced than I am. You have captured hundreds of criminals. You are a professional. You conduct an investigation. You've assembled all the facts. You wrote a report. You did a great job. You did a great job. You did everything right. What is there to doubt?